In this video, we are going to demonstrate the difference between using WebSockets and HTTP for a real-time web-based application. I'm going to use the Canvas demo we published here on Ericsson Labs 2 weeks ago. The Canvas demo is a simple application that replicates whatever is drawn to all other clients in the same room. Updates are sent instantly, so under perfect conditions, the drawing we should see should be simultaneous. The test setup is on a local area network using gigabit Ethernet. The target server is a high-performing quad-core dedicated machine, giving it the ability to process our requests without any delay. What we want to show is how much less processing time WebSockets require for a real-time web application. Let's look at the client test setup. The leftmost window is going to be our drawing canvas. It is connected using WebSockets. On the right, we have two windows that are going to be the target listeners. The first one is connected using WebSockets, and the second uses HTTP long polling. So, how does it work out? At first glance, it would seem that both windows update at roughly the same time. That should not be too surprising, as we're testing at a high performance, high bandwidth, low latency environment. If something looks odd, what if we take a look at 1/10 the speed? Now we see that there seems to be a small delay between the WebSocket client updating itself with new content and the HTTP one doing the same. Due to our test setup, we know that the bottleneck is not the network, so the only remaining factor is processing. Using HTTP as a transport simply requires more processing time. Exactly how much more is that? Take a look at the ping value. This is the amount of time it takes for a small message to make a round trip to the server and back using the current transport. On the WebSocket window at the far left, we can see the ping value for the WebSocket transport. It is fairly low, in the range of 10 milliseconds at idle and up to 30 milliseconds when in use. The HTTP one, however, varies much more. It is 30 milliseconds at idle, and it goes to over 150 milliseconds when drawing is in progress. This delay, which is almost exclusively caused by additional processing requirements on HTTP, is why the WebSocket transport is more suitable for real-time applications.